This presentation was a production of the Animal Science Department at Purdue University.
So the first thing I want to do is get the calf's butt in the corner, get his head in between my knees, and hold it pretty tight so he's not moving around. Got my electrolytes ready. Put some lube, Vaseline, something on the end, so that when I pass it down his throat, it goes nice and easy. Crimp the tube off so you don't get any fluid moving. You can use this little gadget, but I don't. I just think it's too cumbersome. It's easier to use this. So I'm going to gently put it in his mouth. The key is to go really slowly and let him swallow it. So I'm just barely pushing on it, barely pushing. He's going to finally swallow it. I'm just barely pushing on this thing. The calf finally starting to swallow it. They usually jump a little bit. Bury the hard part of the tube clear to the teeth. That's the key to know that it's in their stomach. Lift it up and let it fly. But you'll see the hard part of the tube is right at the edge of his teeth. That's really important. Sometimes the calves will struggle a little bit right now. Don't worry about it. If you got it buried far enough, it's in the right place and you can't mess things up. This calf's doing really good. It's a little unusual how nice the calf's standing. One of the greatest inventions ever is the calf feeder bag. Give him 2 quarts at a time. A couple hours later, it would be best if he would take a couple quarts of milk. And later in the day, get another couple quarts of electrolytes down him. They need about 8 quarts if they're really scouring bad the first day. 4 quarts of milk, 4 quarts of electrolytes. Calf's starting to struggle just a little bit. His tummy's getting a little full. That's okay. Don't worry about it. No matter what, don't pull the tube out. If he starts struggling and you think you're going to pull the tube out, make sure you crimp it first. Okay, that's all there is to it.